We are all convinced that we can save so much time with speeding. So much so, we say,
how long does it take to get there? And then we ask, well, who's driving? Yet, we've all had the experience where someone has sped by us, only to pass them several minutes later, or get stuck at the same red light. Obviously, speeding is illegal. But the question becomes, how much time do we really save if we drive over the speed limit? Do we really know? To answer this, we're gonna turn to science! And Lego sets.
Let's start with the average driver who drives 29 miles in a day. We'll cut that close to half, 16 miles for the purpose of our example. Let's assume 3/4 of that drive is highway miles and the other 1/4 is around town. If you drive 4 miles at 40 miles per hour, it takes 5 minutes and 59 seconds. And if you drive 12 miles at 70 miles per hour, it takes 10 minutes and 17 seconds. Your total drive time is about 16 minutes and 16 seconds. How much time do you save if you go 5 miles over the speed limit? 4 miles at 45 is 5:15, and 12 miles at 75 is 9:36. With a total drive time of 15:01, you can save 1 minute and 15 seconds, which sounds not so wonderful. So let's get dicey. Let's say you're a daredevil and you go 10 miles over the speed limit. Using the same drive, 4 miles at 50, 4:48, 12 miles at 80, 9:01, your total drive time is 13:49. You could save a total of 2 minutes and 27 seconds. So you could say you're actually saving double the time, but the double the time of 1 minute? You've barely been watching this video for 2 minutes, so while I know that's time some of you wish you could get back, it's not very much time. Heck, if you just leave 5 minutes early, you beat someone going 20 over. And if that wasn't bad enough, there's a problem with all these equations. Those equations are all assuming you get to pull directly out of your house, go 4 miles at 40, then 12 miles at 70, and pull directly into your destination. It assumes there is no traffic, no stop signs, no waiting for left turns, or even slowing down for curves. This entire calculation gets thrown out the window the second you come to a stoplight. After you leave your house or wherever, you probably have around 2 miles max before you hit a stoplight. Yes, I know, not to scale. If you're going the speed limit, 40 miles per hour, you'll go that 2 miles in almost exactly 3 minutes, 2:59. If you go 45 miles per hour, you'll go that same 2 miles in 2:39, saving 20 seconds. If you go 50 miles per hour, you'll get there in 2:24, saving only 35 seconds. This is where the entire calculation goes away. The average stoplight is 75 seconds. Heck, even if you're a speed demon going 60, you'll get there in 2 minutes, saving 59 seconds, so you're still at the same light, and all you did was make the road dangerous. Now, I know what you're thinking. That's fine for around town, but what about the highway and the interstate? If we take the same 12 miles as before, you go onto the interstate. At 70 miles per hour, it takes 10:17. At 75, it takes 9:36. And at 80, it takes 9:01. At 75, you save a whopping 41 seconds. And at 80, you save 76 seconds. This means that if there are 0 cars on the road, maybe you could beat the red light. Or you could be the first to hit it. So all 3 of you are still going to be taking the same green light. Some people will say, but if I beat the red light, then I gain 75 seconds. Hold on there, cowboy. That could be true. But the problem is you're still likely in an area with more stoplights and stop signs. So around town, you're probably not saving any time. And even in a perfect world, on the interstate, the most you're saving is 1 minute and 15 seconds. So this happens because whenever you're on the road, it's not just you and the road. You're entering the flow of traffic. The problem is, you aren't in control of traffic, and you aren't in control of the flow of traffic devices either. Stop signs, stoplights, etc. Think about first responder vehicles, like police cruisers and fire engines. They don't drive faster, but their sounds and their lights and the laws of the road help them control the flow of traffic so that they are able to arrive at the scene as quickly as possible. And it works. The truth of the matter is, between slowing down for turns, stop signs, stoplights, and waiting on a left turn or waiting on a right turn or straight up lots of traffic, the majority of your notable time spent while driving is spent dealing with the flow of traffic and the flow of traffic controllers and not actually driving straight to your destination. So, why do we feel like speeding can make a difference? When everyone's driving 60 miles per hour and you start driving 65 miles per hour, inside your car it seems like you're driving a lot faster than everyone around you. You can see cars coming up and you can pass them. You can see cars coming up and you can pass them. It's like all these people aren't getting anywhere. But you are. That's because your point of view is from inside the car. What happens when you look at the same setup from above? Instead of it seeming like you're passing everyone so fast, you start seeing that both of you are moving at a really good speed towards your destination. You're not actually going that much faster.
But on my GPS, the ETA went down. I can see it.
Yes, but was it you that did that? Number one, it's important to remember that the GPS ETA is an estimation by a computer about the real time and changing world, not exact. They've gotten a lot better in recent years, but that doesn't mean the time going down isn't just the computer correcting its estimation. And number two, when it's definitely going down, I'd say it's more likely due to changing traffic conditions than the way that you're driving. Because like we already proved, you can only save around 2 minutes in a perfect world, and the world isn't perfect. Weirdly enough, that means this can all be summed up by the idea that we all know. The drive that usually takes you 20 minutes will take you 45 during rush hour. The point, because of the flow of traffic, when you speed in perfect conditions, the most you're really going to be able to save is 2.5 minutes, which means that if you just left 5 minutes earlier, you'll be able to beat everyone to your destination. You can't beat the flow of traffic. And what we'd all hate is for the flow of traffic to beat you. Every 10 miles you go over the speed limit doubles your chances of being in a wreck. There were 11,258 speeding-related deaths in 2020, so even when no one was on the road, we still had issues. The speed limits were designed for the roads, and everything from stoplights to stop signs were designed to control the flow of traffic and to make it as safe and as fast as possible for everyone. When you speed, all you do is make the road more dangerous for everyone, including yourself, making it less likely that you'll make it to the destination. You want to get places sooner? Don't speed. Just leave 5 minutes early.